Some people hope for a miracle cure.
Some people just accept the world as it is.
I'm not willing to lay down and die because I am an innocent man. I am an innocent man. Oh, yes, I am an innocent man. Oh, oh, oh,
oh. We, the prosecution of the state of Texas, intend to prove that the defendant, Lee Harvey Oswald, acted alone shooting the 35th President of the United States, John Fitzgerald Kennedy, on November 22, 1963, at 12:30 Central Standard Time in Dealey Plaza, Texas. And 30 minutes later, at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time, President Kennedy was officially declared dead by Dr. Kemp Clark at Parkland Memorial Hospital in Dallas. Then, not long after, at 1:30 Central Standard Time, a suspect in the killing of Dallas police officer J.D. Tippit was arrested. Officer Tippit had been killed while patrolling the residential Oak Cliff area in Dallas around 1:10 p.m. Central Standard Time. The suspect in this crime was 24-year-old male Lee Harvey Oswald, who was arrested when he was found inside the Texas Theater in Dallas, possibly carrying a gun, which he tried to use against the arresting officers of the Dallas Police Department. The suspect, Lee Harvey Oswald, while in police custody, was also the subject of an inquiry by Captain John Will Fritz of the Dallas Police Department in connection with the assassination of President John Kennedy. The suspect, Lee Harvey Oswald, worked in a building along the route of the presidential motorcade in the immediate vicinity of the crime. We, the prosecution for the state of Texas, intend to prove that witnesses in Dealey Plaza had informed Dallas police officers of hearing shots coming from the Texas School Book Depository, situated to the north of the plaza. At around 1:15 p.m. Central Standard Time, an assassin's nest was found on the sixth floor of this building, containing three spent rifle cartridges. It was at that time, or around that time, or not long after, that the rifle was found in the immediate vicinity of this nest. The rifle was identified as a 7.65 millimeter Mauser. Later that day, at police headquarters, this rifle was identified as a 6.65 Mannlicher Carcano. That night, FBI agents in Chicago helped trace the rifle, the 6.5 Mannlicher Carcano, to one A.J. Hiddell, P.O. Box 2955, Dallas, Texas. This post office box belonged to the suspect, Lee Harvey Oswald. The gun allegedly found on Oswald at the time of his arrest was also traced to this post office box. And if Jack Ruby had not killed the suspect, Lee Harvey Oswald, we, the prosecution, would have proved that Lee Harvey Oswald acted alone, killing the 35th President of the United States on November 22, 1963, from a sniper's nest, firing the fatal shots through an open sixth-floor Texas School Book Depository window. We, the defense, for the accused defendant, Lee Harvey Oswald, intend to prove that Lee Harvey Oswald is an innocent man and he did not kill Officer Tippit or kill the 35th President of the United States, John Fitzgerald Kennedy. We also intend to prove that the defendant, Lee Harvey Oswald, did not have a motive to commit the crimes that he has been wrongly accused of in this case. And furthermore, we will prove that Executive Order Number 11130 that was signed on November 29, 1963 by President Johnson, establishing the President's Commission on the Assassination of President Kennedy, commonly referred to as the Warren Commission, a seven-member commission that concluded that Lee Harvey Oswald, unaided, was the assassin in both crimes, that was released on September 24, 1964, and signed by all the commission members, was a deliberate attempt to obstruct justice and bring the two parties responsible for the deaths of Officer Tippit and President Kennedy to justice. And lastly, we, the defense, will prove that not only was Lee Harvey Oswald innocent of both of these crimes, he was a pawn in a game used by a covert group who ordered the assassination of John Kennedy, to gain political power. Let us begin by examining the Warren Commission report. The initial research for the truth in the assassination was performed by the Warren Commission, whose members unanimously decided that Lee Harvey Oswald was the assassin of both President John Kennedy and Patrolman J.D. Tippit. It would then stand to reason that the evidence against Lee Harvey Oswald was indisputable. Or was it? Let us begin with Exhibit A, the rifle. If Lee Harvey Oswald was the lone assassin firing the fatal shots to kill John F. Kennedy from an open sixth-floor Texas school depository window, then his fingerprints should have been found on the murder weapon. Would you not agree? I will read now an excerpt from the Warren Commission. Let's see what they had to say. And here is what the Warren Commission had to say about the search for fingerprints on the rifle. A few minutes after the rifle was discovered on the sixth floor of the Texas School Depository Building, it was examined by Lieutenant J.C. Day of the Identification Bureau of the Dallas Police Department. Lieutenant Day lifted the rifle by the wooden stock after he examined it, which convinced him that the wood was too rough to take a fingerprint. Lieutenant Day went on to inspect the knob of the bolt, but he discovered no prints on that part of the rifle. Then Lieutenant Day applied fingerprint powder to the side of the metal housing near the trigger and noticed traces of two prints. According to Lieutenant Day, the FBI ordered him not to make a comparison between the rifle print and Oswald's print. I now ask the question, why? I would like to now provide a possible answer to this question. The answer is pretty simple. Lieutenant Day would have discovered that suspect Lee Harvey Oswald's fingerprints were not on that rifle, which would explain why Lee Harvey Oswald himself would call himself the Patsy. Lee Harvey Oswald was set up, plain and simple. The FBI were deliberately involved in stonewalling any investigation which would prove that Lee Harvey Oswald was innocent.
Some people hope for a miracle cure.
Some people just accept the world as it is.
I'm not willing to lay down and die because I am an alien.